Hello, Javier Orozco from Polytechnic University of Valencia, introducing the way to actually perform impact assessment. Let's go now into the way we can determine the different priorities of smart sustainable cities. In a previous video, we introduced the conceptual framework for identifying these priorities. In our specific model that finally we developed by combining all these elements in a very specific way, which is consistent with the current trend of data available in smart sustainable city, we identify three basic elements: sustainable urban mobility, the development and the design implementation of sustainable districts, and then the integration of infrastructure and processes into them. Obviously, we have different levels on which we need to perform our impact, which is obviously for political level, decision level, and understanding, which is required obviously for all citizens, and last but not least, the availability of funds and the different business models which are correlated. Once we have the structure and the interconnection of the different problems, we have to deal with data. Data today is widely available through many different resources, from elements in the city, like for example road networks, traffic control, parking, buses, sensors which are developed and introduced by the cities, like air quality, air temperature, and even the evaluation of waste, and different data sources. All of them come from different sources. Some of them are owned by the city managers, others are developed by individual companies, commercial companies, and even individuals can provide data with the Internet of Things. All this wide availability of data has to be handled in a way to make it consistent with our framework of analysis, our impact model. For introducing an aggregation of the different data, we have and we need indicators. The most widely choice today is the 232 Sustainable Development Goals, which have their corresponding indicators, which were developed and agreed by United Nations, and you have all the different levels and different layers which are have to be measured at the same time in order to provide a really relevant evolution in a figure, in an indicator. Second, we need standards, because if not, different data cannot be compared. So we need different standards at different levels. And the most important today in smart sustainable cities is the ISO 37120. You have also the website when they are presenting the data for all cities which have accepted that as a standard and correspondingly can be compared in order to see their progress and to see how well they're progressing into sustainability. The key performance indicators have some lapses which have to be overcome, and the European Union developed the Eclipse project in order to introduce the impact of green infrastructure into city and to see also additional figures which are required. A good example of this is the open data platform of Valencia. Here you have the access point, they have sensors, they have a collection of standard data fulfilling the ISO standard and providing also a graphical interface for seeing how all these elements are progressing and changing with time. So citizens can comply and see how all these things are evolving. However, city controllers, city decision makers, need also an insight on what will happen in the future. For that, they need models and they need data projection. They need also the simulation at what will happen. Beginning from the most technical, the mathematical data models, the most complex, like the MBMET software, which is working with finite differences method, also the memory of the different sensors, and their projection with time, which can be done comparing with history, and the most evolved technology, which is data envelopment analysis, which are comparing the different indicators from the inputs to the desired outputs and give a statistical analysis on their evolution with time. So, beginning with the data that we capture, real data, we can construct a model through the data envelopment analysis, that's our framework, and then using the simulation, we can also address the fulfilling of what will happen in the future. So, by combining history and the result of simulation, we can finalize our combined assessment framework to see how the driving elements, the desired outputs with minimum input consumption, can be addressed, and that's done by the DEA model. Apart from that, we have also higher level trends like LIDAR open data, Copernicus climate system, NASA systems like the MERA services. All these are providing additional data that can help in order to check the real performance of our simulation models and then to correct and adapt it on real time so that we can finally know how efficient our solutions are, how the policies, the money that the decision makers are investing in the city can obtain the best possible results. This is all I have to explain in a brief way about the impact assessment framework. Thank you very much.